Do you want to find out how I saw 12 Broadway shows for about $40 each? Today we're talking Broadway box office hacks. My name is Kent and this is your half hour call. Attention cast and crew, this is your half hour call. Half hour to the top of the show. Half hour, please. If you're a theater nerd like me, at some point you will probably want to take a trip to the epicenter of American theater, New York City. And while you're there, you're probably going to want to be one of the 15 million people annually that see a Broadway show. And like me, you're probably not exactly flushed with disposable income, and also like me, you probably want to see as many shows as you can. Either way, I'm going to give you Broadway's best kept secret, how to see shows without going broke. And stick around to the end of the video where I'll give you my number one tip to make your theater going experience more enjoyable. First off, it's important to note that Broadway shows are a high-end luxury product. It's a commercial venture, and there are over 13 unions and guilds that are ensuring that everyone that works on Broadway is compensated fairly. So it's not cheap to operate a Broadway show, and only 1 in 5 of Broadway shows will recoup their initial investment. So producers need to make as much money as they can, as fast as they can, in order to pay back their investors and maybe turn a profit. There's also never been more demand for Broadway entertainment than there has in this past season. So unfortunately, that means ticket prices are at an all-time high. However, producers also want to fill every possible seat, every possible performance. And since they'd rather make some money for that seat than no money and it sit empty, they offer some significant discounts for day-of purchases. This allows producers to have a chance to fill the seat at full price first, but if that doesn't happen, they still get to make some money, and they get to say that their show is selling out. One of the most well-known ways to get cheaper Broadway tickets is the TKTS booth in Times Square. I've never personally used this method, but I've seen the iconic booth and the stairs that are on top of it many times, and I've had some great conversations with the Broadway enthusiasts that they hire to hype up the shows that they're selling that day. Here's how it works. The box office releases certain tickets at a certain discount every morning to the TKTS booth, and tourists line up hours and hours before they open, so they have the first shot at the best seats at the best shows. This is the most popular and well-known option to get discounted tickets, so that must mean it's the best, right? Well, yes and no. While it's great that you can stand in one line and get access to a bunch of different shows, unfortunately, the producers set a discount that's only between 20% and 50% of the original price of that ticket. Even at 50%, the average ticket price is going to be between $75 and $100, and I don't know about you, but that's well outside of my price range for a cheap seat. The next option I wanted to talk about is called Broadway Roulette. Again, I haven't personally used this option, but it seems like a really great option, especially for New York residents. Essentially, you select the date and time that you would like to see a show, pay for your ticket, and then the morning of the show, the program automatically randomly assigns you a Broadway show to go see. You can select plays only or musicals only, and I believe you can eliminate up to 6 options from the list of all the shows. But no matter what show you end up seeing, the tickets are only $49 for off-peak nights like weekdays, or $59 for peak nights like weekends and holidays. The reason I think this is such a great option for people who live in New York City is that if this is the only source that you use to see Broadway shows, the system will track what shows your account has seen and will not send you to the same show twice. So that means if you see enough theater, eventually you will get a ticket to Hamilton for $49. This is also the only option where you can book your seats in advance, and the only option where one person can buy tickets for groups of 3 or more. Again, I haven't used this service, so I can't talk about how user-friendly it is, or whether it's actually as good as it seems, but I thought it was worth mentioning. But what if you don't want to go through a third-party source like TKTS or Broadway Roulette? What if you want to book directly from the box office? Well, if you don't want to pay full price, there are only 2 options that you have. The first is rush seats, and the second is lotteries. Not every show and not every theater participates in these, but most do. Lotteries are essentially a free raffle where the prize is the opportunity to purchase cheap tickets. These prices can vary, and the current lowest price, I believe, is the $10 Ham for Ham lottery. The number of tickets that are available to win also varies widely based on how sold out the show is. Most lotteries allow one person and one winner, to purchase up to 2 tickets. Lotteries can either be digital or in person. Digital lotteries are essentially an online form where you fill out your information, and then 24 hours before the performance, they email you with whether or not you've been selected to purchase tickets. Now, once you get that email, you have a limited amount of time, usually about 2 to 6 hours, to purchase your tickets before they're reassigned to another lottery winner and you lose your chance to purchase them. In-person lotteries function in almost exactly the same way, but they're in-person instead of digital. In-person lotteries usually take place a few hours before curtain for that specific show, and you have to physically go to the theater, fill out a little card, and they'll put it in some kind of fishbowl or a little drum, and a person that works at the theater will physically reach in and draw out names. Digital lotteries are great because you can enter for every single show every single day and still have a chance of winning at all of those shows. The downside is that because it's so easy, way more people enter those lotteries, so your chance of winning goes down significantly. The upside to in-person lotteries is, of course, that not everyone goes to the in-person lottery, and so your chances of winning that specific lottery are significantly higher, but the trade-off being that you can't be in 2 places at once. Pro tip for in-person lotteries, if you're a group of 2 and you're both available to be present at the lottery, you can either split up and go to 2 different lotteries, or you can both enter the same lottery and each say that you need 2 tickets. Ideally, you want to put one of your tickets in at the beginning and one of your tickets in towards the middle or the end to separate them, since the person who draws cards usually doesn't draw 2 that are right next to each other. If for some reason you both happen to win, which believe me does happen, the second person to win just stays quiet, and if no one responds when they call out your name, they'll just draw another card and the tickets go to someone else. You are not obligated to purchase the tickets just because you won the lottery. Rush tickets are a whole other ballgame. If lottery is a game of chance, rush is a game of skill and willpower to wake up at the butt crack of dawn. Rush tickets are a group of seats that the theater has determined that if they don't sell in advance, they'll be available for steep discounts the morning of the performance once the box office opens. These rush tickets can vary in both price and quality. Sometimes I've gotten rush seats that are in the first or second row, and other times I've gotten seats in the back that are partial view. So it really depends on the theater and what seats they set aside to be sold in the morning as rush seats. Like lotteries, there's also a policy that limits the number of tickets you can purchase to 2 per person. So if you have a group larger than 2, you will need at least half the number of people in your group to go wake up early and get in line at the box office. There also may be standing room tickets available. Be sure to ask the box office if this is the case. Standing room tickets are often at the rear of the orchestra, behind the last row of seats. There will be a little plaque on a railing that is right behind the final seat that is your seat and where you are allowed to stand during the show. I'll be honest, I don't know if there are any accommodations made for people who are unable to stand for the duration of the show. Some shows like Come From Away sell their standing room tickets just like their rush seats, so you have to be in line in the morning when the box office opens in order to have a shot at getting them. But other shows like The Book of Mormon only start selling their standing room tickets a certain number of hours before the performance starts. And some shows like Hadestown only sell standing room tickets if every other seat in the house is booked. So not only will you be standing there in line first thing in the morning, but you also might be waiting for those last 2 or 3 seats to sell at full price. Whether you're doing rush tickets or standing room tickets, the key is to get there early. Like, early, early. Most box offices open at 10 a.m. every day but Sunday, which means you're going to want to get there by 8 a.m. at least, even earlier for a more popular show. For the closing night of Slave Play on Broadway, I got there 4 hours before the box office opened, and yet there were already people camped out. By contrast, I was able to rush Come From Away, get my matinee ticket, and then leisurely walk over to New World Stages, where they still had rush tickets available for The Play That Goes Wrong on a Saturday evening show. So those are the ways you can get cheap tickets, but now let's talk specific numbers. For this, I will use my first trip to New York City, which, believe it or not, was actually in January of this year. I was 22 years old, had been involved in theater for 18 years, and was already a member of Actors Equity Association before I was able to make it to New York City, and I do not plan on waiting another 22 years before going back. Now, I only had 10 days in New York City, and my goal was to see as many shows as possible. In the end, I was able to see 12 shows with an average ticket price of $41.50 each. Now, I have to admit, I lied to you. In the beginning, I told you that I saw 12 Broadway shows, but I didn't. I saw 9 Broadway shows and 3 off-Broadway shows. But my most expensive ticket price was actually one of those off-Broadway shows. And if I only calculated Broadway shows, it brings the average ticket price down to exactly $40. I landed in LaGuardia Airport around 5 p.m. on Wednesday, January 8th. The next day, I had pre-arranged in advance tickets to my first Broadway show, The Phantom of the Opera. I had paid $69 for this seat, and it was the only seat that I paid full price for. If you've seen a Broadway show, leave me a comment below with what your first Broadway show was. After paying $69 to see The Phantom of the Opera, New York showed me some love by letting me win the digital lottery for Aladdin, where I paid $30 for my ticket. The next day, I saw Come From Away, standing room only, for $32, and The Play That Goes Wrong, General Rush, for $30. The next day was Sunday, so I saw a matinee of Oklahoma, standing room only, $38. And then I took a day off from seeing shows. Every theater has one day a week that's a dark day, which means they don't have a performance, because everyone that's in the shows and participates in the shows needs a day off. Traditionally, that was always on Mondays, so I took my day off on Monday as well. I used my day off to rest up and sleep in, because the next day, Tuesday, I woke up at the crack of dawn to get down to the Winter Garden Theater and was finally able to get Rush tickets to Beetlejuice, the musical, the musical, the musical. Rush tickets for that evening show were $43. The next day, I did a double feature, and for the matinee, I saw Little Shop of Horrors via an in-person lottery for $29, and for that evening, I was able to do standing room only for Hadestown at $39. The New York theater scene smiled upon me once more, giving me a digital lottery win for Frozen the Musical, which was $30. The next day, Friday, I was able to see an evening performance at an off-Broadway nonprofit theater named the Vineyard Theater. This theater is where Avenue Q got its start, and so many other great shows. The current award-winning show that was running at the time was called Is This a Room, and was in its last week of performances before it closed after a significant extension due to its popularity. I was incredibly fortunate that I had a friend that worked at the theater as their development fellow and was able to get us a 50% discount on their tickets. Unfortunately, this show was so popular that it was completely sold out except for the premium seats in the front row, so I ended up spending the most money of my entire trip on this show at $79 for a ticket. Then, on my last day in New York City, I was able to see a matinee of To Kill a Mockingbird, a General Rush seat for $39, and The Book of Mormon standing room for $40. If you take away the two shows that I purchased in advance, which was Phantom of the Opera and Is This a Room, and only consider the lotteries, Rush, and standing room only, the average ticket price actually drops to $35. Hopefully these tips can save you a lot of money, but the one thing they all have in common is long lines. Over the 10 days I was in New York City, I spent probably over 12 hours waiting in lines in the cold New York January weather. Other than stopping for a snack or a warm beverage on the way to the box office, the number one way you can improve your theater going experience is to make friends with the people in line around you. Odds are the people that are willing to get up at the butt crack of dawn and sit in the freezing cold for several hours just to see a show are as big a fan of theater as you are. You'll also see these people again later in the day when you come back to see the show, because they're gonna be the ones sitting next to you in your Rush seats or standing next to you in your standing room location. Over the course of those 10 days and many hours in freezing cold lines, I met some amazing people, including some aspiring performers who were going to school for musical theater, an artistic director at a theater in the Midwest, and generally just some really cool people. Making friends is how I got backstage at the Walter Kerr Theater when I saw Hadestown. I got to know the people standing in line around me and then standing next to me during the show, and I told them that I was a stage manager from Florida and that this was my first trip to New York City. It turned out that they knew someone in the show, and that person had invited them back to see them after the show, and they asked me to come along, and of course, I said yes. As a lifelong lover of theater and someone who does this for a living, being able to stand on a Broadway stage for the first time was an incredibly powerful moment and one that I will never forget for the rest of my life. and I owe it to the complete strangers who happen to be standing next to me in line. Now, of course, every tip I've just shared is completely subject to change. As of the filming of this video, Broadway is shut down until 2021, and when it comes back, who knows how the policies and procedures surrounding tickets will be changed in order to keep their patrons and employees safe. But whether or not these specific resources are still in practice, theater owners will still need to get butts in seats, so hopefully you can find whatever a post-pandemic equivalent to a rush ticket is. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and please share this channel with your theater friends. And if you've made friends with someone in line, please tell me the story in the comments below. I do not have a Patreon, and I do not plan on making a Patreon. If this fact bums you out, please take the money you would have given me and give it to one of these awesome organizations instead. The Actors Fund, Broadway Cares Equity Fights AIDS, or my personal favorite option, buy a ticket to a local Equity Regional Theater and see some live theater, because it's the best way to learn. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. My name is Kent, and this has been your Half Hour Call.